If you're interested in semen retention and are looking for motivation, me and my team have created a website called semenretaining.com, and the link is in the description below. This will give you a map of what to expect on a journey with hundreds of benefits listed. And when it goes live, you can compare your benefits to other users. Here's a sneak peek of what to expect. Channel is Jay. Today we talk about the science, the metaphysics, and the psychology of semen retention. Now, this is a new concept of my videos, and it's called semen retention success. And I want to link the concepts that I've read in the books I've been reading over the last few years to my experiences of semen retention, because I believe that these books have been insightful, or the lessons I've learned from those books I've really melded well with the experience I've had with the retention. And in this video, I want to talk about the concept of more than filling the space, which is something that I read in the book, The Science of Getting Rich. So I first read this book in 2019, or maybe 2020, late 2018. And yeah, it's very good. It's very metaphysical. It talks about the concepts, metaphysical concepts. And one thing that was very curious in the book was this concept that if you want to get somewhere new, if you want to grow into a new position, a new job position, or you want to, you know, grow your business or your career a new level, then you have to more than fill the space that you're in now. You have to become so good or so vibrationally high that the old space that you were occupying no longer fits you anymore, and life sort of moves you on to the next level. And this is something that I intuited myself. I didn't have to read a book. I intuited this based off my one particular experience that was very intricately linked to my first NoFap experience. So going straight into it, what happened was back in 2015, I had my first ever job out of university, my first ever professional job that I would, you know, proudly put into your CV and say, okay, I'm a professional now. And yeah, this job was really an entry level. I was really in an entry level position, just learning how to, you know, talk professionally, how to interact with people who are professionals, and really just be an adult in that sense. So I was in my early 20s. And yeah, now that I had a job, a proper job, and I was living, you know, away from parents now, I could dictate my food schedule, I could dictate my gym schedule properly. You know, I was driving to the gym, getting stronger, feeling good, really, really feeling myself vibrationally getting higher and more confident. I really felt it. For the first time in my life, I was becoming a man. And incidentally, I started to experience a lot more conflicts at work, and these were things that my colleagues would start. They started to criticize me a lot more. It just felt like if I was really being picked on at work. When I first started work, I wasn't in the gym as much. I was doing home workouts, you know, I was kind of weaker and smaller. I was kind of more, I guess, vibrationally low. But as I started getting to the gym and getting more comfortable, more confident, I just felt there was more of that resistance from them. They had to find something negative to pick up about my work. And yeah, just criticism, everything ramped up. It became so bad that it reached a certain point where my boss had given me this thing called a performance improvement plan. Now, I'm going to admit to you right now, I made some stupid mistakes. That was my first ever entry level role, so I made some stupid mistakes. But this performance improvement plan, I was just doing some research about what it means. There's two camps. One camp is that it's there to make you get better and tell you that you where you're failing. But then there's the other camp, which is from like HR professionals, and they say that that's usually the first sign that they don't like you and they want to get rid of you from a job. So take from that what you will. And I fall in the second camp. I believe the second camp, because the performance improvement plan, I started to fix my mistakes. I really went through, like, they were listing the things that I need to improve on, and I really did that. I worked hard on them, and I never had, so the 3 months after that, I didn't have any of those issues pop up ever again. But then the criticisms were worse. The criticisms started getting even worse at work, and any little mistake that I did was blown out of proportion. And that's when I realized that people were really envious of me, and people just feeling vibrationally mismatched me as I was getting stronger in the gym and just feeling more confident. And most importantly, this is the time that I'd first ever done NoFap. This is the first time I'd actually done NoFap. So I think I'd done, like, this was on a 21-day streak during this period of time. So the things that were happening to me during this period of time, I was getting more confident. I was able to speak with more confidence. I was actually able to be more organized. Things were just getting better and better in terms of my the way I was conducting myself. But the way my colleagues were treating me was getting worse. And this relates to the book, The Science of Getting Rich, in terms of more than filling the spaces, that I was getting too big for my role. I was basically outgrowing my role. And what happened when it came to probation period review is I lost the job. So that was the first time I'd experienced job loss. And it was painful that first, I was shocked. I never thought that I could have it, but yeah, they just told me that it's not gonna work. So the funny thing is that even though I was disappointed with that, like sad, those first couple of hours, that evening when I went home, and even just the first week when I lost my job, I felt like a deep sense of things are going to get better, because I was on NoFap and it's giving me such confidence and such strength that things are going to get better. And so I took, like, just a temporary job, like a call center job, just to keep me getting some money in. And yeah, I was just feeling confident in myself. I still kept up the gym. But I also started doing things like playing outside more and just walking outside more and just enjoying life in general. Actually genuinely enjoying it. Now I was free of all that negativity in that environment. And I was prepared for a pay cut, my next proper job. I was prepared to get a pay cut. I was prepared to go down in seniority, whatever. I was prepared to compromise. But shockingly, I was offered an amazing job. In the same, almost the same field, highest, I'm just listening to things, high salary, had more freedom, had a better team, rationals, people who were rational just like me, more opportunities for socializing, there were more social events, the location of the job was in a beautiful countryside area, the people were just way, way, way better, just friendlier, and I felt like I was at home. That's literally how it felt in my heart. I was literally at home. And I stayed there for like 3 years, and that's where I really developed my NoFap like streaks, and that's where I really got serious with it. But I just felt that when you're a NoFap or semen retention, I'll say more semen retention, the environments that you were in before, you're just gonna outgrow them. And life is gonna force you into new environments that are matching your vibration, essentially. And often these environments are, you're going to get higher pay, you're going to basically be more successful in environments, or the business concept is going to be more successful because you're just vibrationally higher. You just can't be in that lower level anymore. You have to be moved on. And that's what I got from this book, The Science of Getting Rich, that simple concept. You more than fill the space. And when you more than fill the space, it's time to move on. And so things will happen, and it may be negative in the short space of time that's happening, but then afterwards you're like, wow, I'm so glad I moved on from that place or from that experience. Because look where I am now. With that said, hope you have a good day. Take care. Peace.